of some people from the British Isles to Virginia, and some of the versions Betsy does make it. I'll do one more little thing, and we'll bring some other folks into the conversation. Shortly after we moved to Georgia, we met some musicians up in Towns County, old-time musicians. One of them was Ross Brown. We remember Ross. He was a left-handed fiddler, humorous fellow, very good old-time fiddler. And me being the interviewer, I asked him how he learned to play, and he said, "Well, whenever I was a kid, we lived in one of those old houses, and the hogs would run underneath the house, and there was an old sow that would run underneath the house, and there were some splinters sticking down from the floorboards, and she'd run her back against those splinters and play a tune, something in between Bury Me Beneath the Willow and Amazing Grace." And my ambition was to play music like that. So I think he was, maybe he was kidding me, or maybe not. And then he said, "You want to meet some real mountaineers, meet the Eller brothers." So I met Vaughn and Lawrence Eller. Vaughn played guitar, and Lawrence played old-time two-finger banjo, and their mother, Lethe Eller, played the piano. And one day Vaughn says, "I'll show you my other instrument." And he showed me an instrument like this, and he made this one for me, and I tried to string it up because the string had come off, and it doesn't sound right, but this is a mouth bow. He called it a song bow, and this instrument that probably came from Africa and somehow got to the Ozarks and the Appalachians, and it's like, it's next to the voice, it's the simplest instrument because it's got one string, and your head is like a sounding board when you talk or sing. You know, you can make different tones like that. So if you have a little amplification and you have one string, this is not going to be very, very good. But anyway, he said when he was a kid, he would go make one of these, and he'd go across the creek, and his family would be sitting on the front porch of the house, and he would just play a little tune on it, and they'd listen to it, and the music would sort of waft across the creek in the evening. But that was before Florida people and dune buggies came up that road, as Ruby, Lawrence's wife, kept saying. Things were quieter back then. Cindy in the summertime, Cindy in the fall. Don't get Cindy all the time, don't want Sunday tall. Get along home, get along home. Get along home, Cindy, very well. If I had needle and thread, fine as I could sew. So then pretty girls might go tailing down the road I'd go. Get along home, get along home, get along home, Cindy, very well. Thank you.